Yo, that seems good. Okay, cool. So, one second. Okay. Yeah, whatever. Maybe. Hold on. Yeah, let's just do it like this. Yeah, so welcome to Spinhouse Mods, I guess. And it's not long then MudRunner is there. Oh man, they have a new trailer, a new gameplay trailer. They released a new one, and that is so cool. So many good shit in this. Yeah, I would like talk about the trailer a little bit. It looks a lot of things looks they look pretty nice. So, but we'll see. But in the end, this is like Splinters can only get better. And this is a better version in the end. So, yeah, I guess you know if you like Splinters, then you will. It can't be other than and you enjoy that MudRunner as well a lot. So. Yeah, first time console anyway. So, I can make it with that truck. This is like, what truck is it? This is the. It has a strange name. But, I don't know. Lego V. There is a sign like. Oh, let's use the mouse. Let's use the mouse, yeah. TBT 100 Voto, and there's all also like the HY. Yeah, if you know what that is, I think I know. There were more details like which I like. Lego V. By the way, this mod is like from Voto and Tombuggy together, like they work together on this mod. So let me maybe show you which person like is probably responsible for that. Ooh man, where do I have the? Yeah, I should have that. Man, such a cool mod. This one is, I mean, look at that. I think that is also like a real. I think I saw something like this. I'm not quite sure. But I saw something else, which is so fucking cool, and I should use that. I never did like. Should use. I should make a video with that thing because that thing is absolutely cool. I hope I can find it. Oh man. Oh man, all these things here. That is, I hope. We'll see. PC, we'll see. Maybe it gets better. If it's mods, you know. I mean, this is not very, like, you see how that is. So sometimes it's good when you have like a system, but often this is also not so good because it makes it even complicated, more complicated. So, man, where is this? Now I really want to show that thing because let's do just, you know, when you don't know. Oh, there it is. I didn't saw anything like this anywhere. That doesn't mean it doesn't exist, because you don't see a lot of things, they exist. Yeah, sometimes it's a shame, but this thing, dude, oh man. It is fucking good. It drives fuck. It's Lego, dude, you know? I mean, fucking could be any brick shit building stuff, but the Lego today is also not that good. I think, man, the old Lego was so good. Today you find a lot of prefactured stuff, and yeah, that is not really my thing. The Lego is still good. It's still a rarely fucking buy. Go out and buy your kid fucking Lego, man and woman. Man. Why is it? What is going on, huh? Oh, Hold on. The fucking Lego truck, man. You can lumber with this thing. I bring that thing with me. Just to try if that still works. It should work. Does it have? It has no add-ons, so. But it doesn't really need add-ons. But what you can do is, I think you can operate. No, you can't. No, you can't. Oh man, this thing is so fucking awesome, dude. It drives pretty good, I tell you that. It's like a K700 for kids. It's not a 700, I know. But it fucking. Oh man. Drives fucking nice. Oh, there's also no HY. Never noticed that. We should like. Oh man. Soon we have new spin tires. Anyway, my old save game from the pit map was like fucked up. I don't fucking know why. I don't have that many mods. Maybe I have. I don't know. I don't know. I remove all of the mod, all of the trucks on the map. Maybe if I can't imagine that that is worst. I mean, I don't know. Anyway, so I had to start a new game, which is sad. Yeah. So here is the starter garage, and I was able to make it with that truck to the fuel station. You see it? I have like, how much do I have left? This is the MK2 version, by the way. It's like, yeah, I have 46 liters left out of 200. So this is the combination I will roll with, like with the trailer, because the trailer is also custom made, I think. 4 points, you can, I think, 4 points, yeah, TBT 100 over there. Oh, the mud guards, let me check that. There's also Tom Buggy tuning on that. That is fucking cool. I like that, you know? How is. I don't know how to call that. Because this is very. It's not a, like a fucking big sticker on the truck of your side, whatever. It looks not good. It doesn't look good. However, these. Like small little details. I really like these. Yo. So here's another. There's Voto. Stuff like this, you know. Because there's more Voto. Let me try. Come on. Nope. Yeah, there's also Voto on these things here, the horns, I guess. That was there more? I don't know. Yeah, we will check out the trailer, man. Oh man, I can't wait for Mud Runner. Maybe we have some new mechanics. I don't know. We should really talk about that trailer. There's a few things you can talk about. Anyway, so. I was able to make it with this truck. This truck has one. This is the MK2 version, and I think the MK1 version is like the original from Voto, if you want it like that. This one has. Is. The other one is probably also set up, like technical wise, from Tom Buggy, but this one has a different look. And what you. there's one difference I know. Because here on that one you can, on the MK2 version, you can change the tires. They are standard like double tires at the back. And this truck's pretty powerful. So, and I use like the single tires to get here. We'll see, maybe the double tires consume more fuel in the end. We'll see. I mean, it's quite close anyway, we'll see. But I want to do it again with the MK1 version, which is this one. Yo, I have a lot of shit here in the list. Almost nothing is from that truck, so let's talk about the add-ons that this truck has. The good thing is you can see that pretty well because it has the Lego V on everything before it, I think. Yeah, so that helps a lot if you want to know which add-on now is on a truck, because yeah, if you know that shit, then sometimes you have stuff there that is from others. So what I really need to talk about, you don't have much. You have two custom tractors which are fucking, they are fucking awesome. Votos, it's like he has a very specific hand sign, if you want to call it like this. I call it like this. And these add-ons are fucking cool. This is like just a tractor add-on, custom made. And it has the stuff you want. It has fuel and it has repair points. Even he made two versions of that. This one is fucking cool. His add-ons, like Votos add-ons, are always fucking good because they look good, they have good stuff on it, you know, repair points, fuel, whatever. They don't lag. I think they work pretty good because on other mods you see like simple things that you add on that thing and that drops the frame rate so bad. And he knows what he's doing on that. And they fit so fucking good to the mods I know, you know. And check out the Land Rover, man. I should use that as well. I didn't play Spinters for a while, but now, you know, I hype myself up. But these mods, like Pragel has his own hands sign, you know. You see that on every, on many, like, many different things. And you see, oh, that feels like Pragel, that is Pragel. So is this one. Because Pragel has a lot of add-ons on his mods. Others do not so much. Unfortunately, that truck has no cockpit view. It could use one. Tom Buggy, you hear me? Okay, anyway, this tractor add-on is fucking cool. I mean, it has like, where's the freaking, it has, it just looks different. It has like the same capacities of fuel and repair points. So, but anyway, look at this, that fucking tractor. So, and that is the off-road version. And I used the off-road version on the MK2, so I will use the street version or whatever. The normal tractor with this one. And use the trailer. Yeah. Where is it? There is it. Yo. So we have 200 liters of fuel. We'll see. I have no chance all wheel drive the whole way. I also have probably quite more traction now without all wheel drive because of the double tires. And then I want to go into the pit maybe. But I don't know, I don't think I can make it without fueling up again. Yeah, but we'll see. This is the pit map, and I have to say, in 1 second, after I sip a little bit of coffee, that like when you drive in hardcore mode, at least, you need a lot of fuel, because this going in and out the pit, that costs a fucking lot of fuel, dude, so I consider that map a little bit hard. This truck has also quite a bit of fuel consumption, I think, so we'll see. Alright, so let's go. That was wasted fuel right there. So I was like using OnePlus the whole time. Let's do that again. Has a different setup. Okay, I can't detach the trail. Well, I guess it's not meant to be detached. Still. If you have your option to park the trailer, then you should check maybe if you're not going anywhere. You should check if you lifted that stuff. If you know what I mean. I'm Dutch. I can't speak English. I guess I can't make it, dude. If I need overdrive now. But oh, hold on. Hold the fuck on. So this thing definitely has a different setup, because it uses a lot less fuel. I can tell you that right fucking now, because yeah, the other one uses a lot more. Where am I going? Oh shit, I should check the road. Yeah, one way. So then let's try auto mode, but I don't think I can. I mean, come on, in the end you can make trucks go everywhere, but the question is if you want that. I was not going this way, I think. With the other truck. But this thing has a much like harder time than the MK2 launch. So now we'll see. Because it will take damage, which is fucking good. Oh, above is sleeping. Yeah, that's a cool feature, dude. Always falls asleep when you don't. So stop right there. I should use low gear, because you waste fuel and make no progress. And that's what you don't want if you are low on fuel. Maybe the tractor plays a role here. I don't know. Right. Could have different like not features, different, yeah, you know, how is it called? Different, not options, it's just different. Fuck, it's just different. Oh shit, this is a good idea, man. Use one, yeah, don't need one. Shit. Okay, stop right here. I use fuel. What the heck? Ah, great. Good job. Cool. Yeah, and also these deep fucking water holes all over that map, dude. Freaking hard. Freaking hard. If you have a small jeep and want to go explore, fuck you, man. That's fucking awesome, yeah. So that map is quite... Oh, shit. Now that is physics. Something should break. Oh, or flip the truck. Hello. So the winch is quite powerful. It really is. If you think about that fucking big mud hole, okay. Try without all the drive. Liters. Yeah, well, that's not bad. Slow going, but also low fuel consumption. So there's a difference right there between the NK1 and the NK2 version. 26, yeah. Oh shit, I need to... Oh. Okay, is it a mist? Completely different ray, I think, for the first time. The traction is quite different as well, I think. So let's try auto mode. Auto mode, yeah, that thing rocks in auto mode. At least on standard maps. Nah, you can drive in hardcore mode pretty well in auto mode with that truck on standard maps. Heidi halt wieder, hm? Halt der OnePlus jetzt. So, jetzt. Gonna make almost no progress without overdrive, dude. As soon as I hit like mud, the tires will like spin. Oops. Oh, we are here. Great. Oh well. I probably took the same way. No, I didn't. Oh, oh, okay, shortcut. Because I was going like here. You can see that, like, that's also pretty cool. I hope they keep that feature. Like, the map is like cloaked up in the end anyway, so if you drive like through these cloaks, there's then a line where you, so you can see which way it took, but you can see that also when the clocks are removed, I think. Yeah, when you remove all the cloaks, you should still have like this feature that is like still it gets brighter where you like was driving, and I took this road here, I think. And the first time I should took the main road. Oh, anyway. MK2, ah, okay. Is this sound something different? Does it? Yeah, it does. Oh wow. That thing is also similar. 1,200 liters. That's quite a bit. Oh, the truck lower is quite good. That's cool. Yeah, that's good. So the weight is there. That's good. The double tires at the back, they bring probably even more traction with that truck. The MK2 version. Okay. That's a different sound. Isn't it? It is. Is totally is. This sounds great. Oops. Ooh, yeah. And now we can make an override. Okay, so the lowrider abilities are also different on both trucks. I'm not quite sure if the tractor plays a role here. I should know. I could try it. I should try it. Move this. Ah, no, I don't do that now. No, that's bad. Don't do it. Because, yeah. Then there's no fucking test. And also, I lose my repair points. Yeah. So, and this is the reason why I still need a workshop. At least, you're not a hacker. Because you can... you get, like, your repair points there. So let's park this one here. Yeah, that's a cool screenshot. Could be a cool screenshot. Oh man, let's do it. I don't know why I need that. I don't need that. But it looks cool, like here. Yeah. Yeah. Truck. Yeah. Cool. Okay. MK2. Different sound. Even more badass sound than the other one. I guess both are from Tomb Raider. I'm at a few stages, so I can play around with it. Yeah, that fucking worked. So I guess you can make close quarter turns with that truck as well. Okay, so the pit. It's like here. I will have a, let's see. Let's see if I can remember the way. Oh shit. This is the wrong way, by the way. Oh shit. That thing, dude. The tuned version is fucking awesome, man. If you really wanna, like, if you can't do it with the other one, use this one. But it burns out the fuel, so we'll see. Okay, it switches down now. But at least you have 1,200 liters of fuel and some repair points. That's what you fucking want for a logging truck. Fuel consumption is fucking high, dude. In auto mode. But this thing is definitely something else that I can imagine. I mean, there are like targets close to the pit. Oh shit, oh shit, oh my god. To really like go forward with this one, we also go break. We also need like all-wheel drive. But look at that, man. Yeah. No different one. Which way? Yeah, good point to check, like, okay, try to already in the air, okay. But overall the angles, yeah, it's not bad, it's boost. Yeah, for that angle, the trailer doesn't look that bad. But why is this thing not moving? There's a problem. Oh, the tree. Motherfucking tree. Okay. I don't want to waste fuel right now, so let's just do that. Get the keyboard, press X. Fucking stone, man. Yeah, light all-wheel drive, but it's still going, so. Check that angle here. Okay, works. Did I already pass it? No. Oh, here's a way. Is this the way I want this? No, probably not. Can't quite remember that place. That uses no fuel, okay. Oh, there we are. The pit. And we have more fuel than I expected. I thought we almost made it. So, let's go down further. Oops. 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 What? Oh shit, how many fucking meters? Are you kidding me? Oh man, so much fucking fuel. I don't think that is worth it. Horse. The speed isn't like 10 times this. Maybe this, maybe not. But we could just roll, let it roll maybe. Can we let it roll that shit? Yeah, maybe. 200, dude, we used almost that amount of fuel that we used. The amount of fuel we used to get to the pit is almost the amount of fuel we used driving down that far. I don't know. That's okay, I love it. So I think I wasted a lot of fuel here now. That's the thing I fucking hate. That the camera like goes crazy in tight places. Don't like that. So okay. Yep. There is. So here are totally some close range shots. But we can totally go back. Well, let's go over here. Freaking big stone, no problem at all. Let's see. 20 to 40, good one. This is minimum double after fuel. But it goes more constantly.
Okay.
But it slows down. And it's only 40 liters as well. Okay, then I can just use this. And be even more okay. Yeah. Totally. interesting. So when you really need the power, then it's fucking worth it to use overdrive, because that fuel consumption got high even without fuel overdrive. And I use like one, how's it called? That's nice, 90, that's great. Oh yeah, I wasted so much fuel going down here in auto mode, man. Man, it's fucking crazy. We'll see what the MK1 version like is, how he compares to that one. That one is much more powerful, the MK2 version here is much more powerful, but it also uses kind of much more fuel, I thought. And it does use more fuel, but maybe it's not that bad compared to like the progress that you make with that truck, because like good so far. Get back to the fuel station. And then you are really like auto, something like this. It's down here. Yeah, no one. I drive in OnePlus like almost all the time, plus hardware mode. You can use different. And it's still more worth it, like, with this one, because this will go without or a different, but the fuel consumption would be much higher. But the auto mode on this one is pretty fucking sweet. Fuel consumption, dude. Well, you know, fucking good truck. Technically, you know. Yeah, he slows down. Transmission is like custom made, I think. so it goes. Fucking, it fucking goes, dude. But let's save him. Because that bot already is friggin' much. I guess we do that lot shortly, so I can. We'll see, we have a much harder time with the other one. Or we will go much slower, right? This one, it keeps pressing forward. Not a good idea. Oh, there it is. Okay, let's go back into that. Yeah, this is fucking no problem for that truck to get around to all the automobile. It almost looks like that there is already a develop working, you know. Great, okay. I don't need to do that. Maybe the load is stiffer than the other truck as well, I don't know. But yeah, with this one, no problem. I could make it back to the fuel station without, no doubt. I have 1,200 liters of fuel. No fucking problem. And 800 points. Yeah, so you can basically, I did, it's like from the fuel station to the into the freaking pit, get some lumber, get out of the freaking pit and get to like, it's not necessary the forest target from that point, but anyway, yeah, and you can make it back. So you see right there what, how good these trucks are, because that's what you want. You want fuel with you on a lumber truck. Yeah. Anyway. There is the MK1 version. Oh, it's already so much damaged. Why? Or maybe it takes a little bit more damage. Okay, I need to get a coffee. Let's get that thing out of here. Can it be that? Maybe not. Hold on. Let it slide and drive, dude, man. The fuel station's right here. No need to save fuel. Absolutely no need. We can burn through all of that. One freaking second, I'll be right back. Need some coffee. It could take a minute. Yo, okay, so let me just ask a question in that awesome freaking chat, because we need takes a long oh what? I can't do that. Fucking shit. Oh well, oh dude. Why is that not working? Strange. Okay, I can't type things in the chat. Yeah, the new Mud Runner gameplay trailer is freaking cool. We could talk about that. Yeah, especially I think they like show the new 2 minutes trailer. They show like console gameplay, I think. And all these things, you know, the menu looks so fucking nice. Yeah. He loaded up like lumber. He was loading that up at the target point. That would be option also pretty cool. Hardcore mode, always, dude. And the multiplayer day was like... I don't know if that was multiplayer. There are like 2 vehicles moving at the same time, so maybe it could be multiplayer, maybe, I don't know. But the freaking signs are removed, I hope, man. I really hope. Because that is so fucked up. It looks just not good. Oh, damn. Okay, so now I have my coffee. Okay, I can go. So let's see. If there is enough interest, you know, and enough, yeah, how can I say that? Enough reasonable requests, I don't know, they can bring a lot of shit to the PlayStation. If you want that, I want that. I will play that on PlayStation first, I guess. Yeah, I hope I can. If I get the freaking copy. That is fucking awesome. We'll see how that plays out in the console. I can't wait. Multiplayer, oh yeah. Oh man. We'll see how that works. Ah man, it's not long. I fucking can't wait. Playing on consoles like more like convenient for me. Bigger screen and you know the freaking console makes noise. I don't like bullshit. Hold on. I don't have a marker because I'm noob. I need that. I should know the way now in any way without a marker. Yeah. Let's try. But then the test is not like, you know, really test. But anyway. It looks fucking good. The freaking trailer. It's gameplay trailer, so I guess it's gameplay. It looks fucking fantastic, man. Compared like the old version, definitely does. This is like the Prepare to Die edition of Splinter Cell. That is probably a thing. I mean, it's, I guess it can always go worse. It's something, I don't know, but it can, it just can't go better in the end, because it is a better version of a game that already exists. Yeah. And Focus Home Interactive. Their name is like one farming simulator thing. So when Giant Software is the developer, then Focus Home is, I don't know, it's there, you know. So Saber Interactive, they are like, their name is on the Halo Anniversary freaking discs, and the Halo games back in the days were fucking awesome, dude. They were like game. Halo was such a game, they had things a multiplayer that were not really like there before, at least that I know. Like driving in that car with your fucking friends in multiplayer and stuff like this. And that fucking game is so fucking amazing. Look at the enemies, how they are like have an own like character, and they like how they work there on the battle. It's fucking amazing. That is okay. Halo these days is not really my thing, but Halo 1, I mean, in the end, that was the best game. That was the best Halo game. The weapons, too. 60 rounds MG, fucking awesome pump gun. Yeah, that was the best Halo. And Anniversary is not quite Halo 1, because it's almost like Halo 1, but there are some minor changes. And so, yeah. I wanted to play Dark Souls on console, man. That was fucking terrible. On my Xbox, the frame rate is so... Oh man, I can't... I couldn't move on. And on my PC, my freaking controller's not working for fucking some reason. I don't fucking know, man. It's just Dark Souls. Everything else works. Well, whatever. It's also such a game, you know, Dark Souls, with everything after this, like, Bloodborne is an exception, it's kind of a different game. Dark Souls 2, I don't know, these games are like, on the other one hand, these games are not bad, but, I don't know, there should be people, like, they should have the same kind of exceptions like me, like I do, and Dark Souls was a special game, man. It really was. And the whole thing, I don't know. Think about this Miyazaki dude, man. And what he brought into the game, you know. That game is probably, I don't know. Think about that stuff myself. So where is Stairs? So yeah, but Splinters can only get better, I guess. We'll see. But if you count like one and one together, you get three. Maybe. I don't know what focus is like. Focus and Saber. Maybe. I don't fucking know. Maybe there's more behind that whole shit. No, but I guess if like Pavel could earn some money by like having his mud physics in and like a game like a farming fucking game, that would be, I guess, that would be great. So I kind of, this truck is slow going, but it is going, and the fuel consumption is also pretty good. So should I take this one, I think? Yeah. There's a freaking emulator for Demon's Souls, so I have a Demon's Souls copy, but I don't have a PS3, so I can't play Demon's Souls. At one point I thought, you know, oh man, that's a fucking game. Good to have, you know, so I bought it. But I don't want to buy a PS3, only to play that game, because it's still freaking expensive. I thought maybe they are kind enough, maybe, to let us play that game at PS4, but so far, no. Yeah. they probably will never do that. So there's an emulator for PC. You can like emulate your disk or emulate the game, and you need to. How's that going? And what's that way? Is this the right way? There it is. Yeah, you need to bring a disc on PC. And there's the emulator. And oh man, that emulator, the FPS is like fucking terrible. It's not even playable. At least for me, but I don't have. You probably need a very high-end PC for that. i7 plus, something like this. I don't know. I have an i5, so we'll see. I've been through the options and I have everything I should have for the emulator for Demon's Souls, but we'll see. I need to test it a little bit. But if I could play that, oh man, that would be great. So the question is, if the tractor affects that. Because could be that, maybe not. Let's check some. Maybe I can see that here, maybe not. This other tractor. Because on the other truck we have the other one. Can't really see that, but the point should be, in the end, should be the same. I don't think there's like a difference that you notice while driving with the one or the other. I don't know. Probably not. This way. Oh, that's the way, yeah, to the bridge. Yeah. Chain vehicles, yeah. I mean, we are at that point now where we have these freaking chain vehicles now again. But they don't like a lot of stuff. They don't like objects. They don't like bridges. They don't like trailers. So, but yeah, they are in the game, and they are, I have to say, they were pretty good. It's almost more fun to drive that tank here. Like the Abrams tank from the workshop works fucking pretty good. I mean, sometimes it's weird, but that's just what it is. You know, it's the fucking game and freaking whatever. Stuff like this, and the chains and whatever. That thing is almost more fun to drive than the tank in World of Fucking Tanks, you know? And I have to say, I just was playing that game because I like a lot of free-to-play games. Dreadnought, it's a very good game, I think, by itself. Very good mechanics, and I just. People are saying like the World of Tanks space or World of Tanks is completely fucking different, and it's not even a fucking good tank game in the end, I think. I don't know. I mean, you have a lot of tanks there, and it's not my freaking system, because you can have a heavy tank and get fucked up by a fucking light tank that's like few tears over you. And all these things that are like affect a lot of shit. I don't know if that is what you want. That's not what I want, because that there it's tanks only, so it's specific. So a tank is normally, yeah, big tank battles, it's whatever, but I need a good tank game, and that is, it's not, for me it's not fun to play. It's sniper wars in the end, a lot of times. And you have artillery and tanks, light tanks. In the end, if you have a really good tank game, then you can, you have probably more than tanks. So I guess then it would be a game like Armor or something like this. I was playing Operation Flashpoint back in the days, that was fucking cool, kind of, but it was also pretty hard. Yeah, I don't know about armor stuff and how the vehicles work there, but I think you can probably do a lot more. Yeah, you can do a lot more. That's probably a better tank game, or like armor, a game like this. So, yeah. This or that. But Dreadnought is pretty cool. That's a very solid mechanics, I think. Many, yeah, that is. I'm not a, I don't know. Maybe I don't have an idea of tanks, but I guess this is not the way I want to play the game. I like it. But if you do, then that's fine. Let's try with... Okay. Oops. Let's try with a different one. One second, I need to see. Perfect. Yeah, but by the way, tanks. We need more cool tanks in this game, but not like with cannons, like with tools. You know, that is what you need in a game like this. Because tanks are great in this game, but nobody fucking needs a freaking cannon. Yeah. And there was something else, but I forgot it. What was it? Doesn't look that good. I mean, I will make it in the game. Maybe, oh shit. Okay. Yeah, fortunately, that bridge is not that hard. Perfect. Where the hell? Wrong direction. Really? I don't think there's a second entrance in the pit. Yeah, let's try auto mode. Yeah, I guess Tomboy he makes quite some changes, and that causes probably a lot of finger touching. Because this one was not conceptual. Too numb. Tomboy's was like 200 liters. Which is, I don't know, this truck has so much power, then it's really good to have that high of a fuel consumption, because you make a lot of progress with that power. So yeah. Is this easy? Yeah, I know there was a way. I knew it. Probably not the way. First choice with a truck like this. But we can make it. Oops. Yeah. Oh, that's not bad. What? It's not even. What the hell? I'm just used to develop. What? Oh, just straight, great. Auto mode. Yeah. Let's see. I mean, that thing still shifts in the mud and out of here, so it makes progress. So. But this one is also, yeah. It's just a different version from Tomboy, I guess. Because he should be responsible for all the technical changes, not for all the like techniques. And fuel consumption, yeah. It's not even the half. Not even half. 24 liters. I mean, in the end, the MK2 version would go up here with no problem without shifting down. And in the end, if you build up that speed and go up that hill, then yeah, you know what? I don't really know because I don't drive trucks. So, but in the end, it's just physics, you know. So if you have speed and you have weight, which this one has. Yeah. It should go, should probably go up that hill that we just passed that. But I don't know how these mysterious technical things are working. I don't know. They are different, that's what I know from that car. Oops. Yeah, let's use the effective. The much more effective gear. Okay, I already passed that. Okay, let's go just this way. This one, like, I mean, if you look at the fuel and how much I wasted, like, with the other one in auto mode, then I guess the other one, it uses more fuel, but it makes more progress out of it, like, compared to that one. It uses it more effectively because I also was driving around a little bit with that truck. Yeah, that's probably, yeah. So that's, yeah, no test, fuck it. So then forget all what I just said. Because maybe it's not. It looks like that one has, in the end, more fuel consumption. So, but I guess that's not really true. I fucked up the fucking test. Whatever. That's not really a thing. so many different freaking things. The other one was like more effective for all-wheel drive compared to fuel consumption and progress. This one has a hard time going up here, like not really hard, but it's slow going. And consumes like probably like 40. The other one was making much more progress in OnePlus, so, and it was consuming like where it needs power, something like this, like 60 liters, something like this, 60, 70. That one was also more effective on a hill with all-wheel drive. It's fucking magic. Let's use auto mode, let's see how this goes. Yeah, OnePlus is much more option. The transmission are probably different. Power different. What the hell? There's a lot of different fucking things, man. But that thing circles. Yeah, it is. That's fucking cool. Let's go out there first, then see. What? Oh, okay. Yeah, the other one shifts into one plus. Almost very easy. Yeah. No possible with that one. Is there a way? Or let's just turn around. Oops. Okay, so let's just go here, and then we're done. The test is already fucked up, but at the end, I never thought I can make it with these trucks. Like, from the fuel station, into the pit, get out of the pit, and yeah, make it probably back to the fuel station without refueling. So these trucks probably make the charge. Need to deliver the freaking lumber. Yeah, let's go. This one. Oh yeah. Yeah, that was working because the tiles didn't add that much traction. Try something crazy. Let's try to make it up like this. Didn't flip, but poor truck. But I was already saying that I wanted to try something crazy. Don't do that with your truck. Maybe we'll live happy off the walls. Unless I get the gas, it's pretty top.
Let's go.
Alright, there we are. Freaking nice little target. Yay, mud bomb is coming soon. Alright. I need to go. I'm amazed, like, by this truck. You can have a long trip, I guess. Yep, you can. So, praise the freaking sun. Yeah, see you at Mudbrown soon. Oh, yeah.